As a card maker, I know how much fun it is to play around with some interactive cards. You know, those funfold cards. Now, they don't call them funfolds for nothing. So today, I have a funfold card that you can play around with forever. It's a card that never ends. Hi, it's Lynn Dunn from Stamptastic Designs. Thanks so much for joining me today. In this episode of Stamptastic TV, you will learn how to make a never-ending card. It's an endless folding card that just keeps going and going and going. And the best part is, you will be surprised at how easy it is to make this fun fold card. Now, when I say it's easy to assemble, but you do have to pay attention and concentrate when you assemble this card. Now, the cards featured in this video showcase some products from the Stampin' Up! Magnolia Lane suite, but keep in mind you can use any stamp set or any pattern papers you have on hand to create this fun fold card. Just get creative with it. By the end of this video, you will have a fun fold card that you can create for just about any occasion, and it's sure to wow your family and friends for hours. For the latest card making ideas, be sure to subscribe to my channel and click on that little bell so you will be notified each time I upload a new video. Okay, so first let's talk about the supplies you will need to create these cards. So you will need some cardstock that coordinates with the pattern papers you will be using. So for this card, I will be using Early Espresso and Whisper White cardstock because it coordinates with the fun pattern papers from the Magnolia Lane Designer Series paper pack. Now keep in mind, you can use any pattern papers and any cardstock that you have on hand to create this card. I will also be using some of the images from the Good Morning Magnolia stamp set. I will also be using Early Espresso ink, so this is the only ink color that I will be using on this particular card. I am also using one of the oval framelits, the stitched framelits, to create some of the greetings for this card, but you can certainly use any shape that you have on hand to create the greetings. You will also need a bone folder, and I highly recommend some double-sided tape, such as tear and tape, some type of strong adhesive. Since this is an interactive card, you're going to need something stronger than like your snail adhesive to keep the card together, especially because you can play with this card for hours and hours. Okay, I think that's it, so let's get started. Okay, so let's start by creating the base of our never-ending card. Now, you can actually create two never-ending cards with one 8.5 by 11-inch piece of cardstock. So we're going to start by cutting two pieces of cardstock that measure 5.5 by 4.25 inches. Score one of the pieces of cardstock at 1 1/16 of an inch on the 4.25 inch side. Now turn the cardstock and create another 1 1/16 of an inch score line on the other side. Now it's important that you measure and score these pieces exactly so that when we go to assemble the card, everything fits together perfectly. Okay, now that you have the cardstock scored, place the cardstock back in your paper trimmer on the 5.5 inch side so that the score lines are running from left to right across the cardstock. Line up the cardstock at 2 3/4 inches and cut the cardstock in half. Now set these pieces aside. These pieces will be used to create the bottom layer of this card. Okay, so now let's create the top layer. So take the other 5.5 by 4.25 inch piece of cardstock and place it in your paper trimmer on the 5.5 inch side. Score the 5.5 inch side at 1 3/8 inches. Now turn the paper and score the other side at 1 3/8 inches. You should have a 1 3/8 inch score line on each side of the cardstock. Now that you have the cardstock scored, place the cardstock back in your paper trimmer on the 4.25 inch side so that the score lines are running from left to right across the cardstock. Line up the cardstock at 2 1/8 inches and cut the cardstock in half again. Okay, now bring back those first two pieces that you cut and scored, the ones that we're calling the bottom layer, and lay them in front of you so that the pieces are on top of one another and so that they're touching each other. Your score lines will be running vertically on these pieces. Okay, now bring back your top pieces. These two pieces are actually going to get adhered directly on top of the other pieces. But for now, we're just gonna lay them off to the side of each of these pieces. Before we adhere them, we're going to add adhesive to our bottom pieces, the ones that I have in the middle here. So we're going to be adhering our top pieces just by adding adhesive in each of these four corners on these middle pieces here. So the reason I have you laying these top pieces next to the bottom ones is that there's a score line on each of these top pieces. You're going to be adding adhesive to the bottom layer by using this score line on the top layer as a guide. So add a bit of adhesive to each of the four corners on the bottom pieces, so on those pieces that you have in the middle. So you want the adhesive to stay within the scored area on those top pieces. So that's why I recommend laying those top pieces next to the bottom ones, so that you can see exactly where to add the adhesive. Okay, so now that we have adhesive in all four corners, we can go ahead and start adhering our top pieces. So I recommend starting with the piece on the top. So this is the piece that will be the bottom of the card. So we're gonna start by adhering this corner first. Because then once we get that piece adhered, it will make it a lot easier to adhere all the rest of the pieces and keep them kind of tightly together. So all of these pieces of cardstock need to line up perfectly so that when you go to fold and unfold the card, that all the pieces flow together nicely. If they're not lined up perfectly, you're gonna have a hard time opening the card. So this is probably the part that takes the most concentration as you're adhering the card together. Okay, so now that we have the top two pieces adhered together, we can go ahead and adhere this top piece to the bottom section here. So once we have the left side of the card put together, the right side, the top right piece, will go on very easily. Okay, it looks like that's lined up pretty good. We're gonna take that last top section and we're just going to butt it up right against the other top section and make sure that the edges of this piece are lined up with the edges of the bottom pieces. And then we're going to adhere it. All right, so there you go. We have just assembled the Neverending card. Okay, so before we decorate this card, let's open it and play with it a little bit to make sure that it works properly. So the card opens in the middle on the left and right side, much like a gatefold card would. So open it up and burnish down the folds using your fingers. We can use a bone folder later, but for now, let's just use our fingers just to kind of flatten out those folds. Now lift up on the two middle pieces and notice that they open towards the top and towards the bottom. Now we're going to lift up on the middle section again and notice that this time the card opens on the left and right side. And now open the card again from the middle and notice that the pieces open on the top and the bottom of the card. And voila, we are back at the beginning of the card. Now you can go ahead and open the card again and again and just burnish down all those folds using the bone folder this time. So there you go. We have just created an endless folding card, otherwise known as the Neverending card. So now let's decorate it. Okay, so to decorate this card, we are just going to take it section by section. So I'll just kind of walk you through it. There are four different sections to this Funfold card. So of course, we will start with the front of the card. So first, we are going to cut two pieces of patterned paper that measure 2.5 by 1.75 inches. We're going to adhere these pieces to the middle sections of this card. Now we're going to choose a different piece of patterned paper and we're going to cut four pieces that measure 1 1/8 inch by 1 3/4 inches. And we're going to adhere each of these pieces to the four corners of the card. And then the last thing we're going to do is just cut out a small oval from some white cardstock and stamp a greeting on it. And we're simply going to adhere the oval with the greeting to the card front using just a couple dimensionals. Okay, so that is section one. Now let's move on to section two. So we are going to open the card. Remember, the card opens left and right, so that will expose section two. Now for section two, we are going to cut two pieces of patterned paper at 2.5 by 1.75 inches, and we're going to adhere them to the top and bottom center panels. Next, we're going to cut a 1.75 by 1.125 inch piece of white cardstock. We're going to stamp a little greeting on it and adhere it to the top panel of this section of the card. And that's it for decorating the second section. Now for the third section, we have to open up the card. So again, it opens from top to bottom. So we're going to flip the top and bottom ones back to expose section three. So for section three, we are going to cut two pieces of patterned paper at 2.5 by 1.75 inches. We're going to adhere them to the center panels. Then we're going to choose a different piece of patterned paper, and we're going to cut four of those at 3/4 by 1.25 inches. And we're going to adhere these pieces to the four sections above and below those center panels. Next, I stamped a sentiment on a scrap piece of white cardstock using Early Espresso ink, and then I simply cut out the words from the sentiment using my scissors, and then I adhered them individually to the center panels. So for this card, I adhered three words on one side and three on the other side, just to make sure that the words stayed towards the center of the card. That way you only see them when this section of the card opens. Okay, so we are done decorating this third section. So let's move on to the very last section. So this is section four. So for the very last section of the card, cut a piece of patterned paper at 2 by 2.5 inches and adhere it to the top middle panel of this last section. Then go ahead and cut a piece of white cardstock at 2 by 2.5 inches and adhere it to the bottom center panel of this card. And then cut four pieces of patterned paper at 7/8 by 2.5 inches and adhere them to each of the remaining panels on this section of the card. Then go ahead and stamp a sentiment on a scrap piece of white cardstock. For this card, I cut out the words again from the sentiment that I was using, and I adhered them individually to that top center panel. And that is it for decorating section four. And then when you flip it back over, you are right back at the beginning of your card. All right, there you go. Our never-ending card is complete. So now it's time to open it and open it and open it. And open it and open it, and yes, you can just keep opening this card by moving all of these folds back and forth. So once you have the card assembled, it's pretty easy to see how this card functions. Pretty cool, hey? Yes, my granddaughter and I had a lot of fun playing with this card the other day. Super fun. Okay, so now this is the first time I've actually put this card together, and I got the directions for this card probably about 8 years ago from a friend of mine, Penny, and this week was the first time I actually attempted to put this card together. So I hope you don't wait as long as I did to try to make this card, because it really is pretty easy. You might have to watch the video a couple times to get the hang of it, but once you figure out how to adhere it, the rest of it, you can decorate it any way you like. Now, the interesting thing about this card, well, besides the fact that it opens and opens and opens and doesn't stop, is that you can decorate the front or the back of the card. So what do I mean by that? Well, so for this card, remember, we put the card together. I identified these long panels as the top of the card, and I identified these wider panels as the back of the card. Well, we started by decorating the front of the card on this one, but you can use the exact same card and just decorate the back. You can start by decorating the back instead of decorating the front. So you basically put together the base of the card the exact same way that I just shared with you. The only thing that you're going to change is that you're going to, instead of decorate this side, you're just going to flip over the card and you're going to start by decorating this side. So this becomes my new card front instead of this. So on this card, my card front opens top and bottom. On this card, my card front opens left to right. So It's a very simple way to just kind of change up the look of the card without having to change any of your dimensions. The dimensions are identical. Pretty cool, right? Now you have a fun, endless folding card idea that you can use with any stamp set or pattern papers you have on hand. Just get creative with it. And if you enjoyed this video, feel free to download the printable tutorial. You can find the link in the description below this video. Thanks so much for joining me today. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know by liking it and sharing it with your friends. And leave a comment below to let me know what you enjoyed most about the video and the project shared here today. Have fun getting creative. Take care, and I'll see you soon.